Hi, Dr. Matthew Weiner from Commerce, Michigan, here to give you my recipe for a better protein shake. Now, let's start talking about why protein shakes are so popular. And they really have become extremely popular over the last few years, where a lot of people are implementing them as part of their diet, most frequently for breakfast. So there's two ways that protein shakes are commonly used, in my practice at least. The first way is to supplement patients after surgery so that they can get enough protein over the first month or so, as they have a difficult time taking in a lot of food, to make sure that they're healthy and okay. And that's really the primary focus and primary way that I use shakes, particularly this shake I'm going to show you today. A lot of people also use shakes over the long run because they feel, for some reason or another, that they're healthy options for weight loss, and that by drinking them, that it's safe and a good choice for them to have in the morning. Now, although the protein shake I'm going to show you may or may not meet that criteria, I think we can argue about it. There's some good things and some bad things about it, but in general, I think it would be safe for anybody, a bariatric surgery patient or not, to regularly consume this shake. But the commercial shakes, the artificially sweetened whey protein isolate or soy protein isolate shakes that are sold at all of the big box stores and are frequently used as part of bariatric programs, including mine, I'll be the first one. We do use those shakes because they're very convenient for after surgery. But these are not good long-term weight loss tools. They are artificially sweetened. They are heavily, heavily processed. In fact, there's really not a food that I can think of that's more processed than a protein shake. It's a total fake food. It is not a real food. There is no protein shake tree out there that grows these things that makes them a natural product. So my concern is that people use them because they are filling and satisfying. They have a sweet taste, which many patients are addicted to, and you can certainly address that in other ways through the use of fruit. And they're low in calorie. And so people use them to implement a tolerable state of starvation. And we know from understanding our metabolic thermostat that if you starve yourself, if you lower your caloric intake to an artificially low and unsustainable level, that your body will revolt. It will think that you're in a period of famine, and it'll increase your hunger and decrease your metabolism, and it'll work at first, but the second you go back to real food, you will gain weight back at a very rapid pace. Because in the long run, your body is gonna work to defend your initial weight. Our body doesn't just let us lose the weight, it fights back. And it's this, that when the body fights against us, we will lose every time. We do not have the willpower necessary to fight your body's desire to get back to a healthier weight in the long run. And patients can regain weight on something like a 1,500 calorie a day diet if they starve themselves down to a considerable level and slowed their metabolism down. So these artificial commercial protein shakes will induce starvation, which for the long run is not at all helpful for weight loss. So here's the recommendation I make to my patients after surgery. And you can get about 20 to 30 grams of protein depending on the ingredients. I start with a low-fat plain yogurt, and many patients choose Greek yogurt. I think this is great, particularly because the Greek yogurt has a little bit more protein, and you can up that protein shake from 20 to 30 grams by choosing a Greek yogurt. A banana, a little bit ripe, is typically better. I think when it's too ripe, it's a little too sweet. And when it's not ripe enough, it doesn't quite add enough of the sugar taste that makes it more palatable. And then you can either use something called PB2 powder, and I've got a picture of it here. PB2 is something I use frequently with my patients. It's probably the closest thing there is to a natural protein powder. They take peanuts and they pulverize them and they strip out the fat. So it really is just the protein from peanuts. So instead of whey isolate, which comes from milk protein, PB2 uses peanut protein. And you can put 4 tablespoons of it. It does certainly have a peanut taste to it. You can use 4 tablespoons of PB2, or what I personally like to do is just take 4 tablespoons of 100% natural peanut butter. Again, there's going to be some fat in it, but that's really not the enemy here. And in fact, after surgery, a little bit of fat intake is probably going to make you feel better and may, believe it or not, actually accelerate your weight loss. So I personally recommend you use natural peanut butter, but a lot of patients like to use the PB2. And you can actually get a little bit more protein in the shake by using the PB2 because it's slightly more concentrated than you will from the peanut butter. But either one is great. You put it in the blender and you blend it and you blend it and you blend it. It should be very thin when you're done. And the net result is really a delicious protein shake that has at least as much, if not more, protein than are the commercial shakes that many patients use. Also, you can use a little bit of unsweetened cocoa powder to make this kind of a chocolate peanut butter shake, and I'll tell you, it is really delicious. So give it a shot as part of your post-operative recovery and elect to choose more natural foods as opposed to the artificially processed foods. If you want more information, you can pick up a copy of my book, A Pound of Cure, or check us out on Facebook or our growing YouTube channel. Thank you.